You know, central banks have this fascinating toolkit filled with some really clever, almost surgical instruments they use to manage an economy. So today, we're going to dive into one of their most elegant maneuvers, a true financial balancing act.
All right, so it all kicks off with this question that sounds, well, impossible, right? How can a huge institution like a central bank make a major move in the market, but at the same time make sure that move has zero net impact on the wider economy? How can you do something while also doing nothing? That's the puzzle we're going to solve.
Okay, so to get our heads around this, let's start where the action begins. We're going to follow the playbook of a real central bank, the Bank of Israel, as detailed in our source material, and see exactly what happens when it decides to step into the foreign exchange market. Okay, so step one is actually pretty simple on the surface. The central bank wants to influence its currency's value, so it just goes into the open market and starts buying up foreign currency, in this case, US dollars. Seems like just a simple purchase, right? But believe me, this one little action kicks off a whole chain reaction that the bank has to get under control. And yep, you guessed it, that chain reaction immediately leads to a problem. See, in economics, you can't just do one thing without something else happening. It's like a ripple effect. By buying up all those dollars, the central bank has just created a major unintended risk for its own economy.
So you might be wondering, where does the bank get the money for this? It's not like they have a giant checking account. As the source material puts it, they finance the whole thing by essentially creating new local currency. It's the equivalent of printing money and pumping it right into the financial system to pay for all those dollars.
So what happens when you've got a flood of new cash chasing the same old amount of stuff? It's classic economics 101, right? You get this side effect. The total money supply shoots up, and that creates a very real risk of inflation. Prices could start climbing. So the banks fixed one problem, but oops, they've just created a brand new one.
But here's the cool part. Central bankers are smart. They knew this was coming. And they had this really elegant countermove up their sleeve designed for this exact situation. It's called monetary sterilization.
The name itself, sterilization, kind of gives it away, doesn't it? Its whole job is to be a neutralizing action. Its entire purpose is to completely cancel out that side effect we were just talking about, making sure the total amount of money in the economy stays exactly the same.
Okay, so how do they pull this off? How does this neutralizing action actually work? Well, it's not just one move. It's like a perfectly choreographed dance with two steps happening at the exact same time. Let's break it down.
This is really the heart of the whole strategy. So picture this. At the very same moment the bank is doing step one, buying dollars and injecting money into the system, it's also doing step two. It starts selling its own government bonds. Other banks and investors buy these bonds and poof, the cash they use goes right back to the central bank, effectively sucking that new money right back out of the economy. This really shows you the beautiful balance of it all. It's like having a scale. On one side, you're putting a weight on. That's the money from buying dollars. On the other side, you're putting on an identical weight. That's the money being taken out by selling bonds. One hand puts money in, the other takes the exact same amount out. It's a perfect equilibrium.
So after all that, this really sophisticated dance of one step in, one step out. What's the end result? What's the bottom line for the economy?
And here it is, the big reveal. The net effect on the money supply is a big fat zero. Nada, zilch. The amount of money they added is perfectly canceled out by the amount they removed. The bank got what it wanted, but that nasty inflationary side effect, it's been totally neutralized, sterilized.
You know, this quote from the source material really hits the nail on the head. This wasn't some lucky break. It was the plan all along. The entire point of the operation is to make absolutely sure that, at the end of the day, the quantity of money does not change. Okay, so let's do a super quick recap. First, the central bank buys foreign cash to intervene in the market. But that action alone adds money to the system, which could cause inflation. So to stop that, they use sterilization. At the exact same time, they sell bonds to soak all that new money right back up. And the result? They get to achieve their goal, but the money supply at home stays rock solid.
And that just leaves us with one last thing to chew on. We've seen how this amazing tool works for foreign exchange, but it really makes you think, right? In what other situations might a central bank need to clean up its own mess to neutralize the consequences of its own powerful actions?